You give a little, I'll give a little. Let's get together.
You give a little, I'll give a little. Come on, let's get together. That's it!
The idea of playing two people, one from California and one from the East Coast, two very different girls, but twins, identical twins. I mean, I can't think of anything, you know, that more fun, frankly, than doing that.
Don't you find it peculiar that we both look so much alike and have the same birthday? It's just one of those things.
They were identical twins, but they were different and they sounded different. They had, one had a Boston accent and one had a Californian accent. The Californian accent was a little easier for me because I was surrounded by it. The Boston accent was somewhat elusive, and I think that shows in the film. But I was helped by the fact that the twins keep switching places, and they themselves got their accents muddled up, and I got my accent muddled up as well, so we were all in the same boat. But doing the split screen was really fun. That was fun because I got to play each scene twice from two different people's point of view. And I had a wonderful actress to play with. Her name was Susan Henning. And so she was my photographic double. And she's in the film a lot, but it's just the back of her head, which she was really, really good about it, actually. She never complained. And then she went on to become a dancer and dated Elvis Presley. So she got one over me in the end.
Oh, that's a shame. Who is he? Are you kidding? Ricky Nelson? Oh, your boyfriend. I wish he was.
I think I enjoyed both of them equally. I guess, you know, Susan had a more lively lifestyle. I mean, she lived in California. She had a beautiful horse she could jump on, and there was a pool she could jump in. And she had a lot of freedom, whereas Sharon lived in the city and had a very different, much more controlled, disciplined upbringing, living in the house with her mother and her grandparents.
Sharon, welcome home, darling.
She was always well dressed and expected to, you know, say the right thing and mind her manners. And so when she got to be in California, in Susan's life, it was a revelation for her.
I love dancing. I could just dance all night, especially with you, Wilfred.
I think the scene in the dance is fun, where the girls decide, before they realize that they are actual twins, when the girls decide to cut the back of Susan's dress out, and they end up having a terrible fight, which was wonderful fun to do. Unfortunately, I forgot that I had to switch and play the other part in a moment.
Your mother just let you go up in the mountains like that?
Oh, I don't have a mother. Just Dad and me. He's wonderful. Besides, I know most everything about trails and...
I didn't enjoy having the back of my dress cut out. I wore about 10 pairs of knickers that day. I loved the scene with Maureen O'Hara when we are having a picnic together.
What was Daddy like?
Well, I don't know how we got around to him.
Because I loved working with her, and I love working with Brian Keith. You know, it's marvelous to work with really, really good actors. They make you better. What did I learn from working with Maureen O'Hara and Brian Keith? Well, I learned how to behave on the set. I learned how to be disciplined. I learned how not to take myself too seriously. You know, they were consummate professionals, both of them, and really, really sweet with me. And, you know, as I say, if you work with really good actors, they make you better.
Let's get together right away.
I remember about Let's Get Together. You know, we had to shoot Percival Sharon playing the piano in a black velvet dress and Susan coming on with the guitar, which I didn't play well at all because I couldn't play the guitar. But, you know, I'm rather ashamed to say that actors got away with things in those days that certainly they wouldn't have got away with today. I wouldn't have got away with that guitar playing in a film today.
Hallie Parker! Oh, don't do this to me. I'm already seeing double.
It's me, Mum. Annie.
I think she's excellent. It was a funny experience to watch it because it was so, so like the one I did, and yet not. But I thought it was really good. Yeah, really good. And the split screen stuff was so good. I think the movie has survived and is loved by a lot of people is because basically it's a great story. The script was very, very good, written by David Swift and directed by David Swift really, really well. All the actors were wonderful in that film.
Secretly, in their innermost hearts, they must still be in love with each other.
But also I think that it appealed to kids and adults because for children, it was wonderful to see children taking charge of their lives and sorting out the mess that their parents had made. And it came out actually at a time when people started, you know, there was more divorce happening. So it struck a chord there. You know, it's one of those films where all the ingredients really came together really well. The story, the script, cast, the director. It was one of those lucky ones.